Welcome back, everybody. Today we're going to be doing a short 10-minute review on my DPMS AP4 308 caliber rifle carbine. You'll see also here I have my Armalite AR-15 and the 223 caliber. Just going to do a quick little comparison between the two. Starting out with the DPMS, like I said, this is the AP4 version. Just give you a quick look at it. I made some slight changes to it, modifications. Nothing truly major. Nothing was wrong with the gun when I got it. Just I made some changes to suit my needs. It comes with normally it'll come with the regular carbine stock. It comes with two 19-round magazines, not 20. DPMS magazines are 19 rounds. You get two of those. Has a free-floating forearm here, and that helps with the accuracy of the gun. It's extremely accurate. I love it. It's one of my best purchases ever when it comes to firearms. Just to go over some of the changes I made. Oh, one other thing. Comes with a flash hider here. I believe that's a Phantom flash hider. Does a great job at suppressing the flash at night. Some of the modifications I made to the firearm are hole grips. I know a lot of people like the Magpul. I think it's Mag grips. But I prefer the hole. They're a lot more comfortable. Good texture and feel to them. I like the rubber, the soft rubber. Yeah, it's durable. One thing about the Magpul stocks, though, for those people out there who like the grips, they don't fit. There's not a good fit on the 308 version, so be advised of that. I think you'll see it on the website if you go. That's one of the kind of cons with the 308, one of the few small cons that you have, being that even though the 308 version has been out for some time, you have Rock River, has a version, Armalite has a version. You still, the parts as far as aftermarket and secondary parts are still kind of short. Good thing about the DPMS 308 version and the standard AR-15 version, some of the lower receiver parts can be interchanged, and some of the parts you can use on the 223 you can also use on the 308, except for, of course, like bolt parts, because the bolt is much larger. One of the things I'm going to be showing you. And of course the barrel dimension is different, and it might affect the gas tube as far as the diameter of the gas tube if you're in a different gas tube on there. But other than that, this is an excellent rifle. I love it. It's beautiful. Just give you a look at mine. It's a little bit dirty. I went to the range with it the other day. One of the other, I guess some people might consider a con of the rifle, being that it has a 16-inch barrel and it's carbine, and it shoots a very powerful caliber. It's a 7.62x51 308. There's a lot of blast. The recoil on it is somewhat significant. That's one other thing also to note, the change that I made to this rifle. I purchased the, I believe it's called Inandine recoil buffer. Let's see if I can get you a picture of that, if I can. And just simply, I don't know if you can see it well, but just this is my Inandine recoil buffer in there. It actually helps dissipate the recoil, or help you manage the recoil a great deal. That was a good purchase. Glad I made it. I think it's about like $99 or something like that. Some of the other modifications I made, of course, I have a Condor Arms bungee sling on it. That's kind of something that I'll be changing soon. A lot of people going into the single point slings, they work well with the lighter AR-15 rifles, but the 308 rifle is extremely, I guess, heavy compared to the AR-15. This weighed in with a full mag at about 11.2 pounds in comparison to the 9.5 pounds or so for the 223 version. So you can imagine the difference. And using this with a one point sling, it's not a good idea to me. Some guys might not have a problem with that, but that's definitely one factor I'm going to be changing. Look at my rifle too. Some of the other modifications I made, I put a Voltor stock on here. It's very comfortable. Excellent decision. Excellent choice as far as I'm concerned. The Voltor stock comes with several little compartments. You see here I got my extra batteries for my Bushnell Hollow Sight. It's an ACOG clone. And the T reticle that's either in red and green. I put a little mark and a little white out here so I can always make sure that my That's something you might want to always think about when you have a red dot sight. And sometimes you can put it in certain places and it might get jarred, or you might use it and then think you turn it off and not sure it's off. I'll put a little white out here on the end point here so I can make sure. If I see the white out in that point, I know that it's set to off. I left it on for, just to give a credit to Bushnell on the A-Card clone, a little trophy red dot sights. I left it on for 2 days straight and it was still running on the third day. It kind of faded out on the third day, and I was kind of pleased with that to know that it would run that long on that battery. But that's something we definitely don't want to normally do. Back to the Voltor stock, they're just one of the little compartments. They have compartments here, two compartments where you can put batteries. Won't really fit a cleaning rod or anything like that, but you can definitely put some small items there, even spare matches or something like that if you're looking at it from a survival point. What else? The AP4 model comes with a forward assist. Some of the, like the SAS, I don't know if the SAS comes with it, but some of your earlier model DPMS rifles didn't come with a forward assist, but the AP4 does. What else? That's kind of, comes with the Phantom Flash Hider that works well at night. Helps suppress the flash. Before I do that. And what else I want to mention about this rifle? Overall, it's an excellent rifle. A good buy. If you get a chance, you have the funds, pick one up if you can find one. They're hard to come by now. But overall, it's a very good rifle. And just to make one quick comparison, I want to show you the bolt. This is just to kind of give you an idea of the size difference between the 308 bolt and the AR-15 bolt. Major difference for a major difference in power and caliber. But either way, both have their function, both serve a good purpose. Both are perfect in their design, if you ask me. But these are basic gas impingement systems. I don't have any pistons on them, anything like that, but two of my favorite rifles, AR-15 here, and now I'm a DPMS 308. It's definitely a good buy. So if you get a chance, check them out. If you have any questions, hit me up on the email and let me know, and I'll be happy to answer any questions you might have concerning this rifle or any other weapons that you see that we have listed on the site or on YouTube. Thanks for watching, and until the next video, peace.